defense in the second half was really good for us. You know, I thought holding the 45 points in the second half, not counting overtime, was good for us. I thought the start of the game, they had more pop than we had, just, you know, not as fast as we wanted to be. But, you know, JR, Kyle, Tristan, Jeff Green did a great job of stepping up tonight. Not a lot of times when, you know, Bron's going to shoot 12 for 30. So those guys really did a good job stepping up, scoring the basketball, making their shots. And I thought we did a good job of just neutralizing their bench. That's the key to their team. We know DeRozan and Kyle, two all-stars, two great players. But if you neutralize their bench, I think good things can happen. So in that second half, holding DeRozan to 7 points, holding Kyle to 8 points in that second half was big for us.
Joe.
Ty, we talk all the time about confidence for the other guys, but to come in here in a game one and win on a night that LeBron, like you said, shot 12 of 30, what do you think that can do for maybe some of the guys who weren't sure or tentative or whatever from the first series?
I mean, it means a lot. You know, to have five guys in double figures. You know, Kevin and Bron shooting 15 for 43, you know, are two all-stars. So it just shows you that, you know, guys tend to play well. JR 5 for 6 with 3, a big 3 in front of their bench. So, you know, guys got to continue to keep stepping up. That's what the playoffs is all about.
Steve.
Steve Eschner, NBA.com. What was the process that went into putting Tristan on Bell's shooters on the second half in terms of past experience factored in?
Well, Steve, the first half, you know, we went small and put Jeff on him. I thought we needed to score the basketball and give him a different look. And went small. Jeff did a great job in that first half of scoring the basketball. He rebounded the ball well. He was physical with Valanciunas and kind of caught him off guard. We tried to do it in the third quarter. Casey did a great job of adjusting. He tried to, you know, punish us in the inside. So then we got Tristan in that second half and kind of, you know, neutralized Valanciunas a little bit. He had 21 and 21, but I thought Tristan really came in and did a good job of being physical with him, keeping him off the glass, and it's his presence.
Jason Lowe, The Athletic. How do you explain Tristan? Everyone knows how badly he struggled for a lot of this year, and then to come out and do what he did in game 7 and 5 tonight. Where does that come from, and how do you explain this rebirth or renaissance, whatever it is?
I just think, you know, playing in 3 straight finals, long seasons, you know, I think, you know, it's tough. You know, it's tough to get up every single night, you know, for 82 games after the experience of going to finals 3 straight years. But, you know, Tristan knows what's at stake. You know, now every game means something. And I think he's really done a good job of just getting himself in some shape, getting his body in shape. He's more active. Having 9 offensive rebounds tonight was big for us, giving us the extra possessions. We didn't shoot the ball extremely well. So just a credit to him for being a professional. You know, he sit back, he waited his turn, and he was great, you know, while he was not playing. And then, you know, inserted him into the lineup, and he was good for us. So just his hard work, you know, paying off, working out with D-Mill every day, getting his body right, and he's been great for us.
Marla Ridenour, Akron Beacon Journal. If I'm not mistaken, you didn't have the lead until Korver's 3 in overtime. Does that give you kind of a psychological lift when you know?
I just thought early on, you know, I thought they were just moving faster than we were. I thought they were more aggressive to start the game. They really attacked us early and kind of caught us on our heels. And, you know, one day to prepare, one travel day, you know, I think that's how you're supposed to do, jump on us early. But we weathered the storm and we was down by 3 at halftime. And I feel like we was in a great position. And, you know, we just stayed the course. And, you know, like I said, Kyle made that big shot and then, you know, was able to win the game.
Coach in the back here, Eric Smith, Sportsnet. Is there an element to feeling like you've almost stolen on the road to some degree in terms of the last play of the game? Toronto gets 4, looks at the bucket, doesn't come up with anything. Valanciunas in the fourth quarter, as well as he was playing through the game, seemed to miss at least 4 or 5 chippies right under the tin. Open look at the end there for VanVleet. I mean, did you guys kind of escape and steal one here in game one?
I think considering the circumstances, I mean, we definitely stole one. I don't think we played our best game. And I think they know that as well. You know, we, you know, shooting 41% from the field. You know, we usually do a better job. Bron's not gonna shoot 12 for 30, you know? So we didn't play extremely well, but to come in to beat a good team like Toronto on our home floor, like you said, you know, it does feel like we stole one.
Is anything else for Coach Lou? Back up front, Joe.
As we know, you're not much for lineup questions. But given Tristan now through 2 games and just the impact he had tonight, Is that the way you want to go, you think, heading forward in this series?
Yeah, I mean, I like his impact off the bench. You know, just his physicality, like you said, can change the game with his offensive rebounding, his energy. So it's been good for us. I just like what he's doing off the bench right now. We got to adjust at some point, we will. But his presence off the bench has been huge.
Last question on the right.
You talked about the experience that you guys have here. You guys have been to NBA Finals, some of these guys before. How important is that to draw on that, especially on a game like today where you admit your team didn't come out and play their best game?
I mean, well, we're a different team, so we can't really rely on it a lot. But, you know, for the guys who've been here, we've been through a lot. So they understand what it takes, you know, to win games like this in a hostile environment with the number one team in the East. And to come in and play the way we did, we didn't play great, but I thought we played tough. And we stayed the course and was able to come up with a win in a hostile environment.
Thanks, everybody.